Nick, you and I have waited all year for this. It's the most exciting, action-packed 2 weeks in all of sports, and it tips off in today's game between the Indiana Hoosiers and the BYU Cougars.
It's showtime, baby. Let's get the intros and get this one started.
You got it, partner. So without any further delay, let's get this one started. The Cougars should be in for a tough one tonight, Nick. What do you see as the keys to their success?
The keys are very simple, my friend. First, try not to give up any good looks from the outside. Second of all, don't let their big man become a factor offensively. Keep him off the block, push him away from the low box, and force him to shoot jump shots. And finally, don't be passive defensively. Be the initiator and force them to do things they don't want to do offensively.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court and we'll see how this one plays out. Trying to feed the low block. What a reaction.
What a reaction, Brad. The fans are loving it.
The Cougars are going to be at the line for the first time in this game. It's good. Second shot, no good. Rips down the rebound.
They need to get out and run their lanes now.
On the dribble, gives it up. Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I'll tell you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job.
Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
The ball goes out of bounds. Full house. Packed crowd, and they are into it tonight.
I tell you, what emotion, what an edge for the home team.
He stays in control until they regroup the offense. The shooting guard handles the pass. Off the rim and no good. Both teams are looking to get something going here. He shoots way off target. Goes out of bounds. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
From right of the circle, he gets that one to fall. Down inside.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. The small forward receives the ball. The two balls good. Go into the low block. There's a bad pass right to the defender. The point guard receives the pass. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
From left of the circle. The Hoosiers have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Number 30 handles the feed. Number 44 is fired up and ready to go.
Hey, Brad, I love players that play with emotion. That's why I love the college game.
He looks for three. There was no doubt about that one. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. Perimeter. Tries for two.
Look at that try.
There, that's more like my stuff.
Wow. Little Barishnikov right there. You always were a dancer. Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got on the low block. Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. There's the pick. There's the roll. For two. He drains it. Now trying to feed the low block. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
For the bucket. They still don't score. Tough spot defensively in the post, but he got the steal.
Wow, I could have made that steal. He telegraphed that. He was the Marconi guy. What a poor pass.
With a deep shot from outside. Got a nice screen. Gave it up. He puts up the tray. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
Right now, it's a one-man show. The other players need to step up.
Number 10, pump fakes. With the jump hook.
I tell you, didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position. And then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking a shot when you make that turn.
On the dribble, gives it up. There's a double team waiting there. And he missed.
Hey, as a coach, you really like to see your kids get up and challenge shots like that.
A lot of times, a challenge is enough to make the offensive player change their shot in the air. Pull-up jumper from way out. He's typically a good shooter.
Yeah, but not tonight. He's got to accept that.
Gave it up. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Number 45. Foul plus the bucket. Big time play on that one, Dick.
You said it, Brad.
Taunting is definitely a no-no.
That'll definitely rub the opponents the wrong way. He'll go to the line. Got it from the free throw line. Spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. A defensive player beats him to the spot.
On the dribble, gives it up, and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
And the ball goes out of play. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, down here on the sidelines, I'm standing by the losing team's bench, and their coaching staff is reminding them, it's just your nerves. Relax. Once you've settled in, you'll come back.
Dick, they really need to get something going in a hurry here.
Yeah, call a timeout and get your boys into the game, Brad. Oh, poor job. Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball with his deck. Where's he going? Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
He shoots from the angle.
Green was there, but the shot didn't fall.
He keeps his dribble as they reset. Tries for two. The Hoosiers have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
Daddy's on fire.
From way outside. Off the rim and no good. The skip pass is picked off. He shoots from outside. Got it. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure. Just enough to force the steal.
Play results in a backcourt violation.
You have to take care of the rock, baby.
The offense begins off the sideline inbounds. Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I'll tell you, he's trying to front right now. You've got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help some. Push that basketball.
He shoots from right of the circle. Way off target. From downtown. Off the rim and no good. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
He takes the board. Gave it up. And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal them off.
To get the D to bite. And he'll kick it back outside. He wants a three. Way off target. Looking for a good shot.
Two for one opportunity.
There they come with a double team to stop it. The shot from the baseline. It sticks. On the outside. Way out on top. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Number one is pounded on his way up. And he's going to pick up the foul. And oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
This is the team's first trip to the free throw line. Makes the foul shot.
Makes those free throws count. Let's go back on that campus as BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
He's got to pass those off, Dick.
He doesn't trust his teammates, Brad.
Attempts the Hail Mary. With the big shot at the end of the first half. The Cougars lead by six. This one's been a nail-biter so far, Dick. What play do you think set the tone in the first half, in your opinion?
Buzzer beater at the half. Can't be a play bigger than that, Brad.
Well, partner, let's get back to the game and see how this one plays out. Indiana seemed to have caught the turnover bug in that first half, Dick.
And that was big, and it bit them hard. You can't put points on a board if you turn the ball over. They better hope it doesn't come back to haunt them.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
All right, thanks, Aaron. Fakes the shot. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
They'll work it around the arc. Takes away the pass. For two. Doesn't go. On the outside. Trying to draw the foul. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score.
Tempo of the game, really important here. You want to establish a good tempo.
That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
They work it around the perimeter. The center gets the pass. The crowd loves this young man.
Yeah, they really know how to show their appreciation for him.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Hammers it down. Dumps it in. He was looking for the call, and he got it on himself. Offensive foul.
Definitely an offensive foul, no doubt about it. He beats him to the spot.
Entry pass in the paint. Thinks about the shot. Fakes a jumper. He goes with a jump hook. Can't get the shot to drop. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. For the bucket, and off the mark. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Picked out of the air.
Mr. Nestler, looks like there'll be an easy two here.
He gets it to go. From way outside, off the rim and no good. Goes up for two. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Call this a one-man show, Brad. I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing.
Oh, and you talk about a happy group of fans. Listen to this crowd.
Oh, there's all kinds of people standing and cheering and going wacky. Up and inside.
He throws it up from downtown.
Great job of running the defender into the screen for the nice jay.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player, and they made an error, obviously, but they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Here's a spin down in the low block.
I think he's got a variety of moves. Use the sky hook, the jump hook, and add a spin move to the goal.
He uses the shot fake. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. The Hoosiers trail by five. On the inside. Jumps in. He puts it in with contact and all. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Takes the shot. Great shot. Try to come up with a steal, and they do. Looking for a good shot. The small forward gets the ball. He pump fakes. That's the thing about the Big Ten, you know, it's going to be a physical confrontation every time out.
Well, you know, Brad, the Big Ten is known for their physical and bruising brand of basketball.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
At the line. He hits the first shot. Hits his second. If they can get a score, this place is gonna go wild. On the dribble, gives it up. The three, that's good. He can't stay with him.
He's got to get some help from his teammates on D.
He attempts a jump hook. Can't get the shot to go. Gave it up. The center with the ball. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
They'll work it around the arc.
Double team now. Bad angle.
And he missed. Challenging like that really makes the offense think twice about putting the shot up.
It's really almost as good as a block.
Do they need a timeout here?
Yeah, their poise is beginning to fade.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, this is what people wanted. A close championship game. The action and intensity has really picked up down here on the sidelines, and everyone wants to see a great finish.
Makes the shot. Small forward takes the feed. He drains the shot. For the bucket.
Unbelievable. Look at that post position. He can't get a piece of that, baby.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, I don't know if you can hear it, but I can hear it clearly down here. The coach is stressing, go inside, go inside. They've been affected all night long that way. What an asset to have, guys.
Thanks, Aaron.
I'll tell you one thing, you better be able to establish post play because that gives you inside-outside action.
Goes up for two, and in and out. The dribble, gives it up. He shoots from outside. He's doing a terrible job of distributing the ball.
They may have to pull him out and let somebody else out there and let him think about it for a while.
For the deuce. Drops the bucket despite the harm. Applying pressure. Trying to draw some contact. They move it into the front court.
There's the screen up on top.
Gets the ball and now faces his man down on the low block.
Very aggressive player once he got up in the face-up position in the post.
Can we expect a little change in direction here, Dick?
I wouldn't be surprised if the schemes change somewhat.
You can't be that aggressive. You talk about a packed house. Look at this crowd.
I tell you, coach's dream, baby. This gives you that edge.
At the free throw line. Opportunity. Hits the first shot. That line is really being good to him tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
No doubt about it. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
The point guard takes the pass. Dickie's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I tell you, doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making him throw the lob pass over the top. You get help, you can take that pass away.
There's a high screen. The ball goes out of play. And again, let's take a look at that State Farm drive of the game, Dick.
Hey, the ability to get to the paint is one thing, Brad, but he also demonstrated the ability to finish as well. That's awesome, baby, with a capital A.
Picked off.
Line of ball, pressure, help side, it's all there.
Looking for a good shot. For two, rims out. Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick.
They have to foul in order to stop the clock, Brad.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. And the clock stopped with a foul. Yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. Number 20 going to the charity stripe for the first time tonight. Buries it. Interesting to see the level of energy, Dick, when they come out of this timeout. He attempts the three. Off the rim and no good. Pushes it up. Cross court. Jumped in front to take it away.
I tell you, nothing like having those legs, man, when you bounce right off the floor. That high screen, I want to use that high screen. Good jump out, get over the top. That's how you want to defend that. Get over the top of that screen.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
He misses it. Dick, I think the better team won. We can say that, and it's heartbreak for the other club, but. You know, you got to win it, keep on going to get to that final Monday night in April.
Well, I tell you, they won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
The Cougars came, they saw, and they conquered their first-round foe, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, watch out for this team, because the coach has these kids playing with more intensity than they ever did during a regular season. And I'm going to tell you, it's going to serve them well, as now they shift into gear for that second-round matchup.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners, Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.